What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install a mod pack on your Minecraft server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Vanilla Minecraft on its own already offers a ton of possibilities for building, surviving, and having fun with friends, but if you're looking to amp it up even more, then people love to use Forge or Fabric mod packs. These can be small or large collections of modifications that implement brand new features to the game, and in most cases, it changes the way that the game is played entirely. These and other adventures can be a lot of fun with other players, but it requires a server with the mod pack installed. The process to do this is usually difficult to do on your own, but with our pre-selected mod packs, you can start playing in no time. Like I said, our panel makes everything simpler for you to install mod packs. This is achieved by having built-in packs in our system, giving you the opportunity to avoid a manual install. All you have to do is find one you like and then switch it over without having to worry about files, configurations, or extra technical work. We have a ton of options to choose from, which can all be found in our mod pack list that I will leave linked down below. Once you purchase a server, owners will have access to the game file option. This is where you can control what loads in game, such as a specific mod pack. It's essentially a preset of files that automatically enable on your server, but that can still be completely customized through the FTP panel. This area grants you access to all of the directories that make up the mod pack that you choose. As for selecting a particular pack, let's go over how easy it really is. Head towards your Apex server panel and make sure to stop the server if it's running. Scroll down and find the game file section, and then click on the drop-down menu and search for your desired mod pack. Once you find it, select it and press change version in the prompt that pops up. And afterwards, continue to click Create New World and then Restart Now to load the mod pack. Now that you've downloaded it on the server, make sure to install the mod pack on your launcher before joining, since it's required for all of the players to have the same mods. This process can involve using a custom launcher like CurseForge or ATLauncher, and we have a guide on how to do that I will also have linked in the description. If you're unsure about which mod pack to try out, then here's a list with a few things that might spark your interest. Like I said, there are a ton of options, so if none of these seem appealing, take a quick look through our mod pack list to find one that you think looks fun to try. In cases where the mod pack doesn't load on your server, there could be issues with pre-existing files in the FTP panel. This happens if you rapidly change between packs or other game files. To fix it, you're going to have to either manually delete the files or reset everything to load the correct install. You can do this by clicking the Reset Server Files option in the main panel near the bottom left corner, or if you want to do it manually, go into your FTP and select any old files and then press Delete at the top. Once you do either of these things, you can restart the server to successfully load the mod pack. If you're unable to join the server, sometimes joining a modded server can be frustrating since it requires the client to have all of the same mods. Without installing the same mod pack and its version on your launcher, you wouldn't be able to connect due to a mismatch error. Make sure you do this to yourself and tell any other players about it so that everyone can successfully join. If you're unable to choose a mod pack, unfortunately not every mod pack is easy to load and run on the server. This is due to the pack requiring additional resources to correctly function. In other words, you might need to increase your server's memory to select your desired pack. If you choose one without meeting its requirements, a prompt is going to appear asking about an upgrade to get everything working. Some owners may not want to pay for the extra memory though, and if that's the case, you can also manually install the pack through the FTP, but I will warn you, it takes a bit more technical knowledge and a bit more time as well. Mod packs are huge, technical, and confusing, but as long as you use Apex, all of the guessing is taken out of the install and you are left with a new way to play games in less than 10 minutes. So get searching, find the mod pack of your dreams, and jump right in. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.